You're listening to Cross Currents from KALW News. I'm Hannah Baba. Next up is a Hey Area short, bite-sized answers to the questions you ask. Mary Rees wanted to know, can you get a real ID if you're homeless? KALW's Victor Tense found the answer.
Now serving H013 at window number 24.
That is the sound of waiting. Actually, the DMV is pretty much the Baskin-Robbins of waiting. They have all the flavors. Here, people wait in lines outside, in lines inside, sitting down, against walls.
Now serving J002 at window number 3.
So, by the time you get to the window, you better have everything you need. Owen Boochiever found that out the hard way.
And what did you come here to do?
I intended to get a real ID.
And what happened?
I didn't bring the right documentation. It was very difficult to figure out what documents I need online, and I brought my passport as well as a social security card, but I didn't bring enough proof of residency statement.
Owen only brought one, even though he could have brought more.
I own a home in San Francisco. You can like easily look that up online, right? Like I pay taxes on it, but I apparently, you know, it's just very confusing.
Without the right papers, Owen went home empty-handed. So what if you're homeless and have no address?
It made me really think about my clients that come through our doors.
That's Ruth Nunez. She's the director of a homeless advocacy and support group called the Mission Resource Center.
A lot of our clients are sometimes first time being homeless.
And even if they have their personal documents.
Sometimes what happens is people, you know, get their stuff basically stolen. Sometimes if they're unattended, they get taken out and trashed during sweeps. So it really made me think about some of the extra barriers that we're going to create for the population that we work for.
She asked DMV staff if people without addresses could get the real ID. They told her no. I was told the same thing on my visit. Even our question asker, Mary Rees, went to the DMV and they said, uh-uh. So to make sure we had all our bases covered, I reached out to a DMV media spokesperson. And it turns out there actually are exceptions in place for the homeless. Here's the deal. If you have no address, you can submit a letter from any shelter, employer, nonprofit, or faith-based group that vouches for you as a California resident. However, you must still show an official form of Social Security and identification. The thing is, clearly all DMV workers are not aware of this policy. Nunez says that communication failure could be devastating.
When you create more barriers to getting working documents, that means it's harder for you to work. That means it's harder for you to move away from the streets if you're not even able to provide your potential future employment or housing or other places that require you to provide a real ID.
This is a problem, especially for a city with a growing homeless population. According to the last citywide count, there are over 8,000 people living on our streets, and almost a third of them are struggling with homelessness for the first time. To understand what that's like, I went to Dolores Park. I met an unhoused woman who didn't want to use her full name, but identified herself as Janessa. She's been living at the park for the last year without any form of ID.
It makes it harder to go do anything, absolutely anything. Say I want to go buy a pack of cigarettes, and they want to card me. I don't have ID. So if they card me, they can't sell me cigarettes, even though I'm well over 18. You know, so I can't buy alcohol. If I need to buy alcohol, I can't go to the marijuana store if I want to go buy marijuana, you know? I can't go into a food stamp place to get food stamps. I can't go get on housing. I can't go do anything. Really, I'm just kind of stuck.
So yes, there is a way for the homeless to get the real ID. However, between the hard realities of living on the street and the difficulty of getting all the documents in hand, for some people, getting the real ID is unrealistic. In San Francisco, I'm Victor Tense for Cross Currents.
Hey Area is a crowdsourced journalism project where you ask the questions and we find the answers. Go to kalw.org/heyarea and you can submit questions about whatever you've always wanted to know about the Bay Area. And stay tuned, we're bringing you Hey Area shorts every Thursday for the next 8 weeks.